This video goes over the various force field algorithms that Frahm offers. Another video looks at the general controls of the plugin, so if you haven't watched that, you should probably check it out first. We will go through the modes alphabetically. The first of the algorithms is called Bulb. This one keeps the particles at a constant distance away from the center. Particles come in through a small tube and get forced outward, away from the center point, depending on the distance parameter. Another parameter, Wrap, determines how tightly the particles will wrap back to the original positions after they are forced away from the center point. Another parameter, called Mutate, adds imperfections to the spherical distance factor, so instead of the particles being pushed away perfectly spherically, it will be more warped. The second algorithm is called Cross. This one makes particles move to and from along the center axis. It features a rate parameter, which controls the rate at which they move. A shift parameter, which sets how the rate will change over time. And a size parameter, which sets the radius where the particles will originally spawn. This algorithm is called Flow. It works similarly to how the Turbulence algorithm works, which we will show later, but it treats the use of Perlin noise differently. It features a scale parameter, which changes the noise scale, and the morph parameter, which sets how the noise will change over time. Flyby is the most basic algorithm, as well as the default algorithm that's set. It just moves particles from one end of the simulation to another without changing in direction. It features a density and difference parameter, which changes the density of the particles spawning and the range of the movement speed, respectively. Spiral is similar to Flyby, but changes how the particles spawn. In Spiral, the particles will spawn in a circular fashion and move from one end of the simulation to the other, without changing in direction. You can set the direction and radius of the spiral spawning in its parameters. Turbulence is a smooth randomness algorithm in all directions. Particles in this simulation will loop and shake in every direction as they move. You can set the noise scale, the shift, or how the noise will change over time, as well as the spacing, i.e. the spawning randomness. Using this algorithm may change the particles and make them go out of bounds before they actually reach the other end of the simulation. But this is no big deal, as we can crossfade between another algorithm type, which is what we're doing right now. Let's see what this sounds like when we turn it all the way to turbulent, however. This is Undulate. Similar to the cross algorithm in functionality, this one moves particles more smoothly. The parameters are basically identical to cross. A rate parameter, which controls the rate at which they move, a shift parameter, which sets how the rate will change over time, and a size, which sets the radius where the particles will originally spawn. This is Vortex. This algorithm spins particles around the listener. You can set the direction of the spin, as well as a pull and push parameter, which will set the inward and outward force of the spinning motion, so that particles don't get thrown out of the boundaries before you'd want them to. This is my personal favorite of the algorithms. Finally, this one is called Wormhole. This algorithm functions like a wormhole. When particles spawn, they immediately get sucked into the center, and when they approach the end, they get thrown back out. You can adjust the size of the wormhole, the in and out fall off of the wormhole's ends, and the drift, or how randomly the particles will spawn in relation to their original positions. Thank you.